What's up, guys? The Flying Tech here, and today we're going to be checking out something really special. We've got the Wingsland S6 4K pocket drone, so let's check it out. All right, guys, here's the front, the side, the back that gives the description on everything that you get here. All right, let's open it up. It's got this really cool magnet right here. I like that. Right there, that shows quality. I like that. All right, guys, so as you can see, they've got it all nicely folded in the package. On the inside leaflet here, you've got, it tells you about the accessories that you can purchase. It tells you about your safety notice, of course. We have these on the way, and we will be doing a review on these, so make sure to check out the next video as well. All right, let's take it out of the box and take a closer look. All right, right off the bat, guys, look at the quality of this case that it comes in. Now, if this isn't awesome, I don't know what is. A nice little form plastic clamshell that it sits in. Look at that, isn't that gorgeous? You can tell this is a company that takes pride in their product. All right, we got a set of instructions here with a little leaflet. As you can see, they've labeled all of the accessories. Look how awesome that is. As we open it up, you can see all the accessories, and we'll take them out one by one. Here's some extra props and a nifty little sack that it comes in. Next is the battery. That is definitely a proprietary battery. Next up, we have the charger and the micro USB cable. The cable not only charges the battery, you can also use it to connect your quad to your computer. And lastly, a little prop tool that they've included with the kit as well. That comes apart, so you have an Allen key to take the props on and off. Now, I gotta tell you guys, this is a very heavy little piece. The quality of the detail on this model is outstanding. All right, guys, charging is pretty simple. You simply put the battery into the charger, plug the micro USB in, plug it into your computer, and let it run. As you can see, it turned red. It's gonna turn green once it's done charging. All right, guys, let's take a closer look at the S6. Now, as you can see, we went ahead with the camo model. That was just our preference. Now, right off the bat, you can see how tiny these propellers are. I love the form factor of it. All right, so this particular model has a built-in barometer for outdoor flying, but for indoor flying, it's got these two little sensors here that actually send out waves that are picked up by the quad so it knows how far off the ground it is. In addition to that, there's a built-in laser, which is right below, as you can see right there, that also tells it where its direction is in relation to the floor. All right, guys, so let's fold this thing out and see how it looks when it's completely out. All right, when you're folding out the arms, make note that there is no lock. They just kind of pull out and set in place. All right, the onboard camera is a 4K 13 megapixel camera. Now, to lock your blades in place, what you're gonna do is you're gonna firmly but gently push them until they lock into place, like so. Just like that. Let's do it again. One, two, just like that, folks. Talk about attention to detail. The quad came with a SanDisk Ultra 16 gigabyte Class 10C micro SD card. I have to say, it's a very light quad. There is no battery in it right now, but it's very light to the touch. These little holes right here on the top of the quad are where you connect the accessories. All right, guys, one thing we did notice is that taking out the battery is kind of a chore on this guy. You can't really do it by hand. You're gonna need some kind of tool to pry it out. Putting the battery in is pretty simple, straightforward. Make sure that the up is facing up and the arrow is going in, and that's it. It just snaps into place.
Okay, we're gonna start by opening our Wingsland app. Wait for it to load. Have some type of notification. If the temperature is low outside, it'll tell you to heat up your battery in your pocket first before you fly, but sometimes that's not a factor. Okay, we're gonna go to the Go Start Fly. You can start in offline mode. It's going to ask you if you have prop cards or not. I do not. Now, as you can see, it says it's disconnected. We have no satellites or battery. We're in offline mode, but you could still function the app. So we're going to start with settings, a little gear app right there. Now, in flight modes, you could either start in beginner mode, selfie mode, or you can even go into intelligent flight modes. Next, you can control the flight speed. If you're starting off, you know, if you're in a small area, you can start in low speed, medium, or high. Then this is to calibrate the drone right here. Click calibrate. It'll tell you to place it on a level surface. Have you do a twist with the drone, and then it'll calibrate. For when the controller is available, this is to calibrate the joysticks of the controller. And this is just to, if you want to change the name and password of your Wi-Fi signal. Okay, next you hit the 2 hours right here. That brings you to follow me mode or a point of interest mode. Or if you have the three attachments that I have on the way, Bomb Bomb is the pellet shooter, Searchlight is the light that goes on top, and the emoji display is the small little screen that goes on top, which you can all control right here. Which I'll do a more in-depth video when I get those accessories. Then right here is to access your videos that you've taken. The drone's not connected right now, so we can't access them. Simply go back. Then this button right here is to return to home. The drone's not connected, so it can't do that right now. But when you have satellite reception, you're outside, you just simply hit that. If you're in panic mode, it'll bring you right back to home. It sets to about 20 meters, so about 66 feet. It'll rise up to 66 feet and then come back to your position. Takeoff is to obviously have the drone take off. You can't manually just hit the joystick and rise the drone. You have to hit takeoff. It'll rise to a height of about 5 feet, and then you can control from there. Over here is the camera settings button, which you can't bring up unless the drone is connected. This is to change from photo mode, video mode, and this is the capture button. Here is your height, distance from you, your vertical speed, and your horizontal speed. All right, now to get to your SD card, flip it over, swing out this left arm, and it's sitting right there. Has a nice little spring detent, and it just pops right out.
Alright guys, so now we're going to show you how to connect the quad to your phone. First, you want to power it on by pressing and holding in the power button. Once it's on, you're going to go to the Wi-Fi of your phone. Turn it on. Alright guys, you want to connect to the Wingsland S6 Air 004717. That's going to be the way you connect to the quad. Once you're connected, you're going to go ahead and go into the app. It's a Wingsland app that they provide. You're going to choose the one that you have, and that's it. Now we're going to go ahead and go for a flight. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is you want to calibrate the quad. Make sure that it knows its GPS location. There you go. Now we're going to do the little quad dance here. You want to do a rotation, full rotation, until it tells you to stop clockwise. Once it says you're good, you're good. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and start the record, and we're gonna go for a flight.
It's actually really easy.
I'm gonna go ahead and try a little height. Get some 4K video for you. And we'll show you in just a minute here what the video on board looks like. So guys, wherever you press on the screen, no matter where it is, wherever your finger hits, that's what will become the joystick. Doesn't matter where you press on the pad, it becomes your joystick. Which I thought is pretty awesome. All right, guys, we're just cruising around now, checking out the sights. It's slightly laggy. You're definitely gonna notice some lag, but it's not anything that would cause you not to be able to fly. You're not gonna fly this thing FPV, I can tell you that right now. This is definitely more of a camera bird than an FPV flyer. However, you gotta admit, it's got some spectacular views. Okay, we're gonna bring it in for a landing now. You can either simply press the landing or return to home. We're gonna go ahead and do the return to home and let it do its thing. As you can see, it's positioning itself for the descent. It's important to note that if you have it in return to home mode and you touch the screen in any way, it's gonna pull it right out of return to home and you'll be controlling it again. Something else to note, guys, is that you cannot manually land this on your own. It has to land for itself. See, as you can see, it just won't land. No matter what we do, it will not allow a land. All right, let's put it in land mode and watch it land on its own. And there you go. Simple as that. And flight time, you get about 8 minutes, anywhere between 7-8 minutes of flight time. All right, guys, we're gonna take it up for a night flight now and see how it does. On the front, if you can see, it's got green lights. On the rear, we've got orange lights to show orientation. All right, here we go.
covers very nicely.
Alright guys, that's it for us. Thanks for watching. Hope you found this helpful. If you did, please leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe. Leave any comments below. We'll be happy to answer them. And we'll catch you on the next one. Happy flying.